Hello Unity developers, today I'm showing you my new product. This is the negative light asset package. Here you can see on the left side here are positive normal lights and on the right side are negative ones. You can also see here some shadow. You see here some little object from the ornament generator, just a test model just to see here the shadows. And here you also have the same effect here, and in this case these are some kind of inverted shadows. And in this video now I show you how to set it up. So let's go. First we have here the shaders. These are under negative light, and here you can select those standard shaders or the custom negative light one. If you use PBR materials, then you should use the standard shaders or the standard specular, dependent on your workflow. It's the exact similar shader. If I change this, for example, to standard specular, then you see the only thing which changes are the lights here, and of course the shadow is not negative here. So let's change it back to this shader here. You can see here in the settings are exactly the same with the addition of the light mixer here. Here you can set the strength of the positive and negative lights here. Like I can disable completely the negative ones or enable it or make the power of this stronger. See how it changed. I recommend values of 0.5 each one, or so that the sum of the negative values and positive values are 1. Like if I disable the second pass now, so I set this to 1. Why we have this negative light mixer, I will explain this later on. But first, now I show you how to set up the lights. Here you can see some negative lights. I called it evil lights because yeah, they are evil. Now I move it around and go here. And now here comes the fancy stuff. Now it's positive. Here, this is the normal positive light, and it becomes negative if this alpha value here goes close to 0. If I keep it to 0, then you see here it's completely a white negative light, and you can see how positive lights and negative lights will fight together. And depending on the light mixer, one light type will win over the other one. So it's they want blend together and create a completely gray matter, for instance. But you can see how they are suppressing each other. Here you can see how I can also change the color, and of course it's not the typical red, green and blue, but in this case it's red, cyan and magenta. These are the subtractive colors here. And you see here, if I keep it to make it yellow, I end up with the rest, which is blue, because the red and green colors are extracted out of the surface here. Now I show you the concept. This is the normal standard shader. Standard material, you see the difference. The lights are completely the same, the lighting is the same. See here the specular highlights. And you can also change stuff here like this, inverted. This means there's the first light, the direction light can be inverted. Now it's inverted, so the whole starting mesh is inverted now. Let's set it back to the original values here. Now here you can see the sample PVR substance here. It's just a test material. So here you can see the output textures with the procedural patterns here, and here, except instead the standard shader, I've chosen the standard negative light ones. So the next thing I want to show you is the custom shader. Here we have, let's go to the custom sample. It's very, very similar. What this does is it looks completely similar to the standard shader, but it combines all the Gacy shaders into one. So now let's check it out. Here you have main texture, bump map, texture here, the specular map, the shininess, metallic map is for the reflectivity of the reflection probe, and here you can also select the light probes. You can set to Phong and to Blind Phong. You can see the difference between both Phong and Blind Phong. The specular highlights are a little bit different. And here, additionally, you have also the option to add rim light. The settings are not that. Have to play around here, but therefore I have another test material set up here. Like this material here, you can see the rim light, and of course this one is negative, a negative rim lighting. Now this is the positive one, and if you set it to negative, now it extracts out the yellow colors here. You see here, if I disable it, you can see the white light completely creates the rim lighting, as it has the most influence here. The red one is completely sucked away by the light white, but now I extract out the yellow values, so the blue is the rest, and of course the red ones are here. So now I can show you the rim lighting in more in detail. Here we have a gradient map. Here we have some sample gradients. If you don't have a gradient, I've implemented here a gradient editor. I can open it, and now you have here some a very, very little tool here. You can change here your gradient, like you can make it as you like. You can even create unusual gradients like this. And I type the name here, my gradient. I create the gradient, and now it's in the asset folder. Here is my gradient, and I put it, throw it here in, and we have used the gradient. So here you can have the power of the rim light, of course zero, very little influence. Thing happens, and it's too positive, and you see here the it gets stronger and stronger, but I would recommend some lower values. Here you have the influence of the bump map. Here is very little influence, and now here we have the lookup multiplier. This is used to get the value from the rim map. Now if I increase it, you can see how what will happen if I recommend very, very low values, like the standard value is 1, but I would even recommend something. I have to try. The best one, the standard value is 1. So here you have the rim lighting, and you also have transparency settings. You can set it to cutout. Therefore, we need some bold texture. I see here it's the wrong texture, and the cutout let's revert to the previous material, and now the fade one. Let's lower the transparency. And additionally, you have the possibility to set the cull mode, set it to off. And you have here the sphere. It's the interior. Or the play around with the. Some sphere. Now, the last thing I want to show you is when you now the light mixing here. And therefore, I have another sample for you. So here we have the tests for light fighting. Don't save. And here you can see what will happen depending on the light mixing settings. Now, here obviously the light test one. You see only two passes are enabled. The bottom pass here is always the strongest one, so it has the most power, and this is the one which will survive. So the in this case the white, the normal light gets completely destroyed by the negative one, and you end up with see how it will suppress the positive one. The light, negative light, is just way too evil. In this case here, you see some kind of gradient here, and you see here that the last one is the positive light here, it which survives. So this is a little bit stronger because it's the last one, but the negative one has more power. So if I merge it together, you see how the strong center of the positive light will come out alive, but the weaker sections became dark because there is more influence from the negative light. See how it destroys the outer part. Here we have everything normalized here, so you have some mixing that you see how it mixes a bit, but the black light negative one is stronger. And this here, let's try this on. Here the positive one is bigger. And the negative one is the last one which comes out alive. And here is the opposite. The black light gets completely eaten away by the white light. And now I want to show you the last thing. It's not the last thing. One additional thing I want to show you. Here we have the same stuff but with shadows here. You see, if lights with shadows collide, here is one negative and one positive. Remove it, of course, you get some bump light, bumpy light. It's a bump shadow. Yeah, it's very, very weird. First time I saw this when I created this. So here you can see the if positive and negative lights with color comes together, then the result. Think shadow will look something like this. Now here we have the test material. It's just some test mesh. Well, I hope you like this asset. It's very, very fancy. I know many people have asked for such negative lights here, because it's still very, very uncommon stuff, but some games won't have it and some people want it. So I show now the The RGB values here, you can see the color gradient and how color subtraction and the color addition here. Slide here. Here we have the negative one and the positive one. So actually every light shader with lighting can work with negative lights, but there are some little exceptions here. It does not work with baked lights. So if I set it to baked and you make the light mapping, the light will be positive because the light map is applied in a normal sense. So you have to use the normal real-time lighting. It also works with if you make it to spotlight. Yes, the spotlight. And of course also with direction light, but I would recommend that you use positive lights for direction lights. But it's up to you what you're doing. So the limitations are it costs more performance. So if you are on mobile, I recommend to use the X2 versions. The only difference is that they only have here one pass for each different type of light. So in this case, the negative ones will always win over the positive lights. But here you only have two passes instead of four or more. So if you have requests for shaders, like there are many others out there, for example Toon or any shaders, I can implement it so to support the negative lights and put it into this package. But you have to just contact me and write the subject shader request and then put the source code of the original shader or at least some source so I can see what you wanna see implemented here, which shader should support inverted lights here. So I hope you like this asset and see you later, bye!